Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you about a very common issue that many of my subscribers are facing, that is Xampp is not starting, or you can say Xampp is getting unexpectedly closed. So if you go to this Xampp control panel, this Apache server will get start properly, no issues on that. So here you can see that it is properly started, but for MySQL, when you click on the start button, it's going to first, you know, start, will attempt to start, but after that it's going to show this error that MySQL shut down unexpectedly. So MySQL is not getting started. So I'll try it again. So you can see the process ID is assigned, and then again it is showing the same message, right? Now this issue is actually happening because of, you know, some sort of corrupted files in their data folder. So we'll go to this Explorer, and here you need to go inside this MySQL folder, and you'll see this data folder over here. Just simply go inside that data folder, and here you can see we have a lot of files and folders over here, right? So here you can see that we have this employee DB that we have created, players DB, student DB. So these are all databases we have created when Xampp was working fine, but then suddenly it was showing this error. So what the solution that I'm going to provide you will actually help you to get all the data that you have created back also, right? So you're not going to lose any data. So what Xampp has actually done is Xampp has provided one sort of backup solution, you can say. So if you go to this, you know, backup folder, so here you can see we have again these files. So what we need to do is we need to rename this data folder, okay? So we are going to right click on it, and we are going to, you know, click on this rename, and we are going to rename this with underscore old, right? And what we are going to then do is we are going to create a new folder, and this folder we are going to name it as data, right? So currently data folder is empty. So what we need to do is we need to go to this backup folder, and we need to copy everything. We are going to paste that over our data folder, right? So once our copy is done, what we need to do is we need to go back and remember that old data folder that we have created. So here, as we know that previously we have created this employee DB and players DB, student DB. For your case, it will be your whatever database that you have created, you should be getting those, you know, database folder over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all those folders that I have created. So employee DB, players DB and student DB. Along with that, I am also going to select this MySQL and this IB data one folder. Okay. I mean, this is file and these are all folder. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to go back to that data folder, and I'm going to simply paste all that. All right. So as we know that MySQL folder is already there, so that I'm going to replace with my old data, and it is all done now. And now if you simply minimize this and go back to our Xampp control panel, now if I just simply start this, you can see status change detected as we have changed those files, and here you can see it is, you know, up and running. So it has properly assigned our port, and it is running. So if we now go to the admin, you know, control panel, the PHP my admin, so here you can see that all the databases that we have created, so student DB, you can see, so all the things that we have created earlier are actually not lost. You have we are successfully able to retrieve all that. So student DB is the the student is our table, so everything whatever there are rightly back over here, right? So you know, that's the small hack. So I observe like the issue is mostly happening because of some problem in the log file. I don't know exactly why that file gets corrupted and this issue happens. So probably you might observe that even after this fix, maybe after a week or 2 weeks, we'll again going to see the same problem. So one thing is you do the same process all over again, whatever I have showed in this video, or else probably you can try to by upgrading our Xampp. Probably that will that might solve your issue. Alright, so that's pretty much all about this video. Please put a comment in our comment sections and let me know whether this video really helps you. And if it really helps you, then please put a like and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. That would really help me to make more such videos. I have also started a vlogging channel, so if you are interested, you can also watch the vlogging channel. I'm going to put that link in the description. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.